This is Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and we've just finished off one of our spiral classifiers. And what this does is it classifies material by size. There are three different size discharges. We have it set in the lowest one. And the fine material stays suspended in the water and washes out into the tailings. The coarse material augers up the trough and down into a bucket. We have it set right now to about 50 mesh plus. So here's all your 50 mesh plus. And then discharging out into the tailings is your 50 mesh minus. We're running right about 10 gallons a minute through this right now. I've shut the spiral off now so we can see what's going on down here. And how this works is the trough is about half or three quarters of an inch below the spiral, and the spiral augers the sand up and it creates a sand bed that lines the bottom of the trough, and then the sand that gets augered up over the top just rides up the sand bed all the way to the top of the auger here. This is a 12 inch diameter auger and it's just over 12 feet long. It sloped at 3.5 inches a foot. We're looking down at the basin end of the spiral classifier, and how this thing works is the material from your concentrator, shaker table or spiral bowl or sluice will dump into the basin here. Faster settling velocity pieces will fall down through the water, land on the bottom of the trough, and get augered up and out of the spiral. The finer material, that which can stay suspended in the water, will flow up and out the hole in the side and into the tailings pond. Now this is really dependent on the amount of water you put through the basin. For example, if you try and flush 5 gallons a minute through a teacup, nothing will settle in the teacup. But if you flush 5 gallons a minute through a swimming pool, only the very finest fine smoke will come out the end of the swimming pool because the basin is so large. It has a lot of area to settle in. So the deeper you make the settling basin, if you open this hole and plug this one, it would make the water level up to here. It's like the swimming pool analogy, and only the very finest material would be suspended and flow out the top. Here is some of the material that augered up and out of the sand screw. You can see it's anywhere from maybe 1/8 inch particles down to about 40 or 50 mesh. And then here is the 50 mesh minus. This is the backside of the basin where the shaft comes through, and we use a stainless shaft running up through the pierce point in the basin so it doesn't corrode. And this is a packing gland that allows the shaft to come through the hole but not leak any water through or grit. This is the drive side of the classifier. We have a 60-to-1 gearbox, further reduced by a chain reduction, so the final RPM of the spiral is about 7 RPM. This is one of our tester motors. The final motor that goes to a client is a 2-horsepower three-phase motor, which is plenty of power to turn this thing. So this is one of our newer products, the spiral classifier. I appreciate you guys watching all our videos. This one's got to be boxed up and sent off to a client here tomorrow, so I wanted to get a quick tutorial video on it and show you guys how this worked and what the application was. So I appreciate you watching, and I will see you on the next video. Thanks.